Alright guys, Ryan here, Fletch Deep TV. I'm just going to do a quick little recap of this week's hunt. I got to go back, do a little bit of hunting this weekend. We did see one of our target bucks. I believe it was can opener. Still not 100% sure on that. The closest he ever got was 150 yards, looking through binoculars. So not 100% sure, but I do think it was him, and we'll show you the footage on that. As you notice, it's finally cool enough where I can film out in my garage without sweating to death, so that's another plus. So hopefully trends continue and it gets a little bit cooler. I'm hoping these cooler temperatures start to stick around. With that, I'll go ahead and start showing you the footage.
Alright guys, it's my first morning sit here opening weekend of Kansas. We had a little bit of a thunderstorm last night, so temperatures have dropped. It was mid-50s this morning. It's probably up in the 60s by now. This morning, I'm sitting in one of my favorite stands. I'm in a big oak tree right on the edge of a hay meadow and a creek. Usually get some decent traffic here in the mornings. So far, no luck, but it's still early. So hopefully before too long, we can get some footage of something. Unfortunately, I forgot my mount to mount my camera to my camera arm, so what little filming I get will be with the GoPro on my bow, so, well, wish us luck, guys. Little bit of action here this morning. I was actually trying to film the crane down in the creek trying to eat some fish, and of course every time he would try and grab a fish, he would step behind the tree or just move just out of frame. So unfortunately I didn't get that, and while I was doing that, I was afraid the whole time there's going to be does, some deer sneaking the hay meadow to my left here, and sure enough, as soon as that crane walks out into the opening, I turn around and there's two brown flashes streaking through the field. A doe and her baby. Don't know if they smelled me where I walked in or what, but they were not having it and I didn't get any film of it. So if I was a cameraman solely, I would be fired. So hopefully I have a little better luck. It's only about 8:20. So we'll give it another hour or so and get down, pull some cards, and get ready for this evening's hunt. So,
alright, stay tuned, guys. Evening hunt of our opening weekend. This is the Saturday. Right now we're setting up for a big open bean field. Buff's right up to cut corn, and we're right on a tree row with a creek about 40-50 yards that way. to our right, so they like to funnel through these beams. We got tons of trails right here in front of us, all sorts of deer tracks. Hopefully they're coming out a decent time in the evening and not way late at night. Pulled the trail card. We'll probably check that while we're sitting here in the stand, so hopefully we got some good deer on that. So wish us luck, and hopefully we'll be showing you some deer here before too long.
Unfortunately, guys, my GoPro camera does not record audio as well as I would like, so the interview I did in the stand didn't turn out so well, and my camera lady had my main camera down in the stand below me when we did move to our new location to try and get on that buck a little bit quicker than right at dark. So what we did is we moved about probably 200 yards west in the field, trying to get a little closer to where they're coming out and bedding from their bedding. And they like to hang out on that west side of the field for quite a while before they start working their way east to the cut corn, which they will browse through at night, it seems like. So unfortunately, there's not a ton of spots to hang a stand down on that west side without getting right up in their bedding, which I think even now where we are might be a little bit close. So what it is the landowner that we hunt on, his brother used to hunt. Unfortunately now he's too old to get out and hunt, so he has left a lot of his stands out there on the property, and usually when we find where his stands are, they tend to be pretty good locations. So as luck would have it, we were looking down there looking for a stand location, and we found one of his ladder stands. Unfortunately, it was only like 8 feet off the ground, so what we had to do was I put my camera girl, I let her sit in that, and unfortunately left it a little too brushy. I was really worried about her getting spotted, which she kind of did, so next time we're going to have to work on that somehow. But I put my ladder on the other side of the stand, and have a hang-on hanging about another 8 feet above her. So unfortunately, we weren't able to communicate as well as like we usually are sitting closer together. So we had a little bit of issues there. We did have a couple does coming close. One was about probably 6 feet away from her, just staring right at her. Unfortunately, she couldn't get any footage because she was too scared to move without spooking the deer. So we didn't get any on that on footage. I probably should have turned my GoPro around, but I was waiting for a shot opportunity to present itself where I knew she would be able to film and get so I could get the shot on film. So unfortunately, we didn't get to harvest that doe that night. We did get a little bit of footage, so I'll show you that here. But I've got some high hopes for the stand. Really can't wait to get back there, especially when the wind's right and a little bit closer to late season. I really think it'll be a great spot to hit some rattling horns around once late season comes around and deer start responding to that. So stay tuned, guys, and hopefully for too long, like I said, we'll be able to show you some footage sending an arrow Fletch deep. So stay tuned, guys.